Hey y'all, welcome to the video. If you're watching this video, you're most likely wanting to know about sinus surgery, and maybe you're considering having surgery. Maybe you're suffering from symptoms related to sinuses and just trying to understand those better. Maybe see if you're a good candidate for sinus surgery. I will let you know that I had the full house sinus endoscopic surgery. And I also had a septoplasty. As far as nose appearance or whatever, I still have the same ugly nose. So that wasn't affected. If that's something that you're worried about, it did not affect the appearance of my nose or face in any way. I did not have any kind of bruising, scarring, you know, nothing like that. A little bit of swollenness, you know, initially for 2 to 3 days while it was healing, but otherwise nobody could tell that I had a whole lot of packing and stuff shoved up there. In regards to what made me want to have the surgery, so a few years ago I started to develop a lot of signs and symptoms that were related to sinus issues. However, at the time I thought that they were allergy based. I had been diagnosed with asthma. I'd been having a lot of allergy symptoms such as stuffy nose, runny nose, watery eyes, that kind of thing. And I just figured it's because I'm allergic to a bunch of stuff. But over time, you know, I tried Allegra, I tried Zyrtec, I tried the sinus rinse, I tried a vaporizer, everything. And it only seemed to be getting worse. And it got to the point where at work, I would have to just shove a tissue up my nose.
So I know that this is really gross, but I just want to give you a good example of what I'm going through when I'm having an episode. So underneath this mask, I have this shoved up under my nose, and you can see just all the, this is completely soaked, all of the mucus and congestion that is coming out of my nose. While I'm trying to work and eat and function, and it's just really miserable. And I cannot get this surgery fast enough, I'm telling you. Cannot wait.
It was just continuously running, and I couldn't just be, you know, wiping my nose with tissues nonstop while at work. One good thing about the mask, to cover it up so nobody even knew, but I was just miserable at work. I didn't want to go anywhere or go out of town. God forbid I get on a plane, because with the altitude, it was just bad. The closest thing I can relate it to when I try to tell people about the symptoms I was experiencing was that, you know, when you cry like really, really hard, I mean like really hard, hysterical cry where your nose gets soft up, it's running, you have like a massive headache and congestion right here, your eyes are watery, you feel extremely exhausted and drained and just overall miserable. That's exactly how I would feel when my sinus symptoms would come on. And it could be, I could be fine and literally I sneeze one time and that's it. It's over, like I'm just gonna for the rest of the day be experiencing that. I would get up in the middle of the night to go to the bathroom, and as soon as I would go from laying down to standing up, my nose would just immediately clog and then just start running. I would have to just place a tissue on my pillow so that it could just drain into the tissue rather than my pillowcase, which I know is really disgusting, but that was the reality that I was living with what seemed like every single day. And you can ask my wife, I'm sure she would vouch for me that I went through so many boxes of tissues, so many medications and different methods trying to get this under control, and nothing was working. So I finally decided that I would go see an ENT, and that's exactly what I did. And he took a look up there with the camera, and he immediately noticed that I had sinus polyps and I had a lot of inflammation. It was almost completely clogged up there, like he couldn't even get the scope that far up there because there was so much mucus and drainage going on. So he said, you most likely have chronic sinusitis. I want you to go get a CT scan of your sinuses and we'll get a better look that way. So I did that the next day. And while in the scan, the lady asked me, like, how long have you been dealing with this? This is the worst case I have ever seen. I said, when can I get in for the surgery? Let's do it. If it works, you know, 10% improvement, I'm willing to spend the money and the time and everything because I am at my wit's end with this. So we scheduled the surgery a couple weeks later and I did it. The surgery went really well. It did last a little bit longer than they anticipated because I did have so much going on in there that they had to get out. But overall, it went really well. It lasted about 4 to 5 hours. As far as post-surgery, not that bad, except for the first 2 to 3 days. I really felt just yucky. I was like nauseous, but also like hungry. My stomach felt empty, but also didn't feel like eating. I dropped maybe 10 pounds. I would say uncomfortable was the best term to describe how I was feeling, just uncomfortable with all the packing in your nose. I had stitches on the inside of this side, so it was pretty uncomfortable and it hurt a little bit, but I didn't really have a lot of pain. I just had a lot of pressure in this area and I had a really bad headache. I also had a very sore throat for about 3 days from the intubation. Like my throat was on fire for 3 days. But then after that, it went away. Now I was prescribed an antibiotic that I took for maybe 10 days just to make sure you don't get any kind of infection. I was also prescribed Tylenol with codeine for pain, which I only took, I think, twice because it made me have really weird dreams and I just felt like super drugged up. I'm very sensitive to medication, so I feel like for me, just the extra strength Tylenol was okay, so that's pretty much what I stuck to while I had a headache. But otherwise, I was told to do a sinus rinse twice a day with the saline packet. And if you're not familiar with a sinus rinse, this is the main one that I see, the Neelmed sinus rinse. It's basically just a salt packet that you empty into this water. So you're gonna fill this up to this line with, I prefer warm distilled water or boiled water, however you like it. And you fill it to that, then you pour in the packet and you lean over the sink and you squirt it in, you squeeze this and squirt it in one side and the water should come out. Now, initially after the surgery, you have packing, you have swelling, you have blood, you have a lot of stuff in there. So it's gonna be very uncomfortable because it's gonna feel like you're shooting it in and nothing's coming out. But I promise that once you get that packing out, it will be a lot easier, it'll feel a lot better, and just continue to do whatever your doctor says. From all the things I've heard about sinus surgery and it not working, it's been because the patient did not follow the instructions post-surgery. If your doctor says do a sinus rinse once a day, you need to do that. If your doctor tells you to take a certain medication or do something, you need to make sure to follow that or else this could all be for nothing. And in my case, I know what it was like to have all the symptoms. I do not want that again. So I'm gonna do whatever I'm told to do to avoid this in the future. He did prescribe me mometasone. Not sure if I'm pronouncing that correctly, but it's actually a lung steroid medication. However, I don't take it orally. So I take the pill and I pull it apart and empty the pill into my sinus rinse once every morning and shoot it up my nose. And that's how the medication gets into my system. And it's supposed to help with inflammation and preventing that and keeping everything good and open in there. So I did go for a follow-up visit a week after the surgery to have the packing removed and for him to take a look at how everything was healing. I will say that that was extremely uncomfortable and very painful. So a lot of YouTube videos and things that I read mentioned that you should take the pain medication before you go. And you know, I didn't want to take the Tylenol with codeine because it was so strong. but I did take a couple of extra strength Tylenol, and I don't know if it didn't work or what, but it was very painful. He was basically just removing lots of like clots and scabs and gunk out of my nose, which it did feel good to get it out, but at the same time, my nose was on fire afterwards. After I left, I had the worst headache, and my nose was in pain for the rest of that day. I felt immediately better the next day, and I was able to breathe and sleep, because once I had that packing in post-surgery, I could not sleep very well at all. Even when I was elevated trying to sleep, I would feel like a post-nasal drip in my throat, along with not being able to breathe at all through my nose. So I felt a lot like I was drowning or choking. And I really dreaded the nighttime, honestly, when it was time to go to bed, because I knew that I was just gonna lay there for most of the time. With all that said, was it worth it? Was it worth the money? Which I would say, between the visits, the follow-ups, the medication, the anesthesia, the pathology, all that stuff, it probably cost me about $5,000 to $6,000 total with insurance. I would say 100%, absolutely, it was worth it. I would totally do it again if I had the opportunity. And I would recommend anyone that is struggling with sinuses in a serious way to consider this surgery, because it has changed my life absolutely for the best. Before this surgery, I had not been able to smell anything in over 8 months. That of course also affected my taste. I could taste very, very spicy foods or very, very sweet foods, but I could not pick up on any kind of subtle flavor. Kind of gets to you after a while, like the scent of a good candle or a home cooked meal or whatever. You don't realize how much those things mean to you until you don't have them. You know, not having to carry boxes of tissues everywhere I go, not having to worry about if I get on a plane. There's so many things that I would have to worry about, think about. Now I don't have to worry about that. And I thank my surgeon and the medical staff and everybody that helped make this possible, because it has really been the best thing that I've ever done. 2 to 3 days of being kind of miserable and feeling yucky, a week of not being able to sleep very well, was well worth it to live the rest of my life being able to breathe normally and smell and taste and experience life without that worry. So if you think you're a good candidate for this surgery, I would definitely consult your doctor and talk to your family and make sure that you're financially able to do it. Do this surgery and you will not regret it. And if anybody has any questions, if you would like a separate video on a specific topic, such as like how to use this thing, let me know. If you'd like more content on my symptoms or the actual process of this surgery or what or the cost of it, just let me know and I can do that for you guys. But I hope you enjoyed it, and please give this video a like if you found it helpful in any way. And I'll see you guys later.